Can you solve this geometry challenge? Here's the question. Given the circle, let's draw a chord measures 45 centimeters. Now from here, on this endpoint, let's draw a perpendicular segment that is measures 20 centimeters. And again, from this point, let's draw a perpendicular segment that is measures 15 centimeters. Now, the goal in this question is find the radius of this circle. Pause this video right now and see if you can answer this question, because I will show you the answer and the solution in 3, 2, 1. Alright, the answer to this question, or the length of this radius, simply equal to 25 times square root of 10 divided by 2 centimeters. Now the question is, how do we get this result? And here is our solution. In this video, I will show you 2 different methods to answer this question or to find the length of this radius r. And the first method I will use is the Pythagorean theorem. We love Pythagorean theorem. And the second method, I will use the radius of the circumscribed circle, or simply by using this formula. The radius is equal to ABC all over 4 times the area of the triangle. By the way, this A, B, and C are the side length of a triangle inside our circle. Now, let's begin with our first solution using the Pythagorean theorem. I don't see any right triangle, but take note, this is a right angle. So if we extend this segment measures 20 centimeters, and we connect these 2 endpoints, we created a right triangle. And now also take note that when a right triangle is inside our circle, then the hypotenuse is simply the diameter of this circle. In short, when we get the value of this segment, let's call this as A, then we can now solve for the value of R, because we know the diameter simply equal to 2 times R. In short, our goal first is to find the length of this segment, A. And to do that, what we're going to do is to use the symmetry of this figure. And to do that, let's extend this segment measures 15 centimeters like this. Now, what we're going to do is to put this segment, this entire segment, into these endpoints. And let me show you the process. It looks something like this. Now, from here, we created a rectangle right over here. In short, the opposite side is simply equal to 45 centimeters. Now, if this is 45 centimeters and these 2 are symmetric, in short, this segment right over here is 15 centimeters. It looks something like this. From here, we can now use what we call the power of a point, or simply the chord-chord power theorem, to find the measure of this segment, A. Now, using the chord-chord power theorem, we can say that A times 20, or 20 times A, equals 15 times the sum of 45 and 15, or simply 60. And in short, if we divide both sides by 20, we get that A equals 15 times 3, or simply 45 centimeters. Now, we know the value of A. We have this A as 45 centimeters. In short, we can now find the length of the radius R, because we know that this diameter is simply equal to 2 times R. Again, using the Pythagorean theorem, in this right triangle, we get 2r raised to the power of 2 equals 45 squared plus 65 squared. 65 because 45 plus 20. Now, simplify this. We have 4r squared equals 45 squared is 2025. 65 squared is 4225. Adding these 2 together, we get 6250. Divide both sides by 4, we get 6250 over 4, which is equal to r squared. Get the square root on both sides, and sure enough, we get that the value of r, or the length of the radius of this circle, simply equal to 25 times square root of 10 all over 2. And that is the length of the radius of our circle. So using the first method, we get that the length of the radius is simply equal to 25 times square root of 10 all over 2 centimeters. Now, let's proceed to our second solution. So we're done in the Pythagorean theorem. Let's proceed to the second. We have the radius of the circumscribed circle. So let's start. To answer this question using the radius of circumscribed circle, we need to have a triangle inside our circle. And to do that, what we're going to do is to extend this segment, measures 45 centimeters like this, and connect this to this point to create a small rectangle on the top. Now, since this is a rectangle, the measure of the opposite side are equal. So this is 15 centimeters and this length is 20 centimeters. Now, let's connect these points to create a right triangle with the legs 15 and 20. Now, the question is, what is the hypotenuse? So this right triangle reminds me of a 3-4-5 right triangle, because if we multiply 3, 4, and 5 by 5, we get 15, 20, and 25. In short, the hypotenuse of this blue right triangle is simply equal to 25 centimeters. Now, let's connect this point to this point to create a triangle inside our circle. And the question is, how do we get the length of this segment? So using this right triangle, and again, using Pythagorean theorem, so the hypotenuse is simply equal to the square root of 20 squared plus 15 plus 45 or 60 squared. Now, let's simplify this. 20 squared is 400 and 60 squared is 3,600. Adding these two together, we have 4,000. And simplify this. This is 400 times 10, or simply 20 times square root of 10. Now, we are now ready to use this formula and find the length of the radius of this circle. So let's begin. Now, A, B, and C are the side length of this triangle inside our circle. So this happens to be 45, 20, and 20 times square root of 10. All right. Now, how about the area of this triangle? So we use 1/2 times base times height. And the area is 1/2 times 45, which is the base. And the height of this triangle is 20. In short, the area of this triangle is simply equal to 45 times 10. Now, using this, we can now solve for the value of the radius of the circle. So we replace this triangle, or the area of this triangle, as 45 times 10. Now, upon simplification, take note we can eliminate this 45, this is just 1. And this 20 and 10, this is just 2. Now, 4 and 2 cancel out, this becomes 2. So, in short, the length of the radius is simply equal to 25 times square root of 10 all over 2 centimeters. Therefore, our answer to this question, given this figure, then our answer is 25 times square root of 10 all over 2 centimeters. And of course, before we end this video, let's have an extra challenge. Now, given this figure, the goal is to find the length of the radius of this circle. And as always, we are done.